Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us here on Horizon. Well, while unemployment is still at record highs in some parts of the country, there are still jobs going unfilled. According to the Department of Labor, there are as many as 3 million job openings nationwide, many of these unfilled because applicants do not have the requisite skills. And nowhere is that more acute than in the STEM fields. Joining me now with more is our Andy Barth.
Rob, the word STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math. And it is the lack of skills in those subject areas that is the cause of many of our job vacancies today, and the prospect of considerably more in the next few years, which is what is behind a nationwide program called Viva Tech.
It seems like a typical day in the classroom. Students working at tables and furiously writing down notes. But for these 8th graders at Monroney Middle School, it's anything but typical, and all things engineering.
Right now, our statistics show we rank 17th in the world in production of engineers.
Ben Robinson is a retired brigadier general and says engineers are an invaluable resource to our world.
If you look at what engineers do for us, well, it's engineers that developed our cell telephone capability, it's engineers that design new cars, it's engineers that develop space exploration capability, agricultural engineers show us better ways to produce food, design new farm equipment. It is engineers, biomedical engineers, that help us develop new drugs to fight cancer. It is biomedical engineers that develop artificial hearts and artificial arms and legs. Just about everything in our world that gives us a great quality of life come from some kind of engineering, science, technology, or mathematics programs.
And that kind of impact is why these students are taking a hands-on approach to learn about math and science.
We just need more representation, more numbers in our STEM fields.
All right, do you guys want more time?
Loren Cisna is the Education Programs Coordinator for Great Minds in STEM, and says the lack of people working in the STEM field needs to change.
We really need to get more people into our STEM professions, into our careers. We know that the jobs are there, but the high school diploma doesn't suffice. The recession hit, but the jobs relating within the STEM industry is available to us, but however, we're starting to export our jobs over.
Fewer jobs, in part because of fewer graduates. Per capita, the U.S. now trails countries like Estonia and Turkey in STEM graduates. In fact, the U.S. has fallen all the way to number 23.
We're not the leading country in the world, so therefore we need to get our students. They're already interested in technology. You know, they love texting, they love being on their computers, they love, you know, being on Facebook and things along those lines. And so we're asking them, why not make that a career? It's a viable career choice.
And for Monroney Middle School student Catron Wilson, the concept and activities come as quite a surprise.
I certainly didn't expect building anything. I thought we would watch some videos about what we were going to do when we get to college and stuff like that.
For Wilson, a day like today is right up her alley.
I've enjoyed building the little house we made. I enjoyed building the rockets. I really do enjoy it. I like to build things.
And for classmate Briley Taylor, this is the perfect alternative to classwork.
It was fun. I would pick this day over any school day, any day.
But aside from the break of regular class, students worked together and tested their skills on projects suitable for the military.
We built a facility for the Tinker Air Force Base.
We used newspaper, tape, and teamwork. It was really easy because we had a good team to do. We had a good team to do and everything, and it was really fun. I had fun.
And while it's fun and games for these students, Career Tech's Becky Foster says one of Oklahoma's leading industries is losing valuable workers.
Oklahoma is a shortage of engineers, short of a science specialist. So in Oklahoma, we are really going to have to grow our own to be competitive in the global economy.
And the hands our engineering future rests in belong to these 8th graders.
Today is a great example of how we can engage students at an earlier age. Part of the problem is some of the students don't even know the possibilities of STEM jobs, salaries. So it is exciting today because we are educating 8th graders. And so the younger we can start educating, the more important it is for them to stay long-term in STEM jobs.
One, two.
Launching themselves into a bright and promising future.
Now, there are many more kids who would like to go into STEM careers than generally recognized, but they aren't properly prepared and mostly drop out.
And I've read that despite all this emphasis on STEM education, we are still actually still kind of falling further and further behind.
Rob, it is a multifaceted problem, but the most common stumbling block for many students is mathematics. And experts say if students don't master Algebra 1 by their freshman year in high school, they will have bleak prospects when looking for a job.
All right. Thanks so much, Andy. Now, a little later in our show, we'll head to NASA's Johnson Space Center with some Oklahoma teachers trying to put the fun back in science.